Warburton's, who more or less followed on after Fred Dibnah, John Warburton, tell me this is the 90th chimney that he's felled. He's done them brick by brick, a whole lot of others, but he's just done 90. This is the 90th chimney that he's pulled down. So they started with pulling a few bricks out.
As you're cutting out, you've got to take half a chimney out for it to... You're actually only cutting out, and as you're cutting out, you're propping, going along propping. We use telegraph poles. And all you're doing is you're taking it out till there's enough to hook out, you're balancing it. It's only on them, and then when you think you've got enough out, build your fire, props burn away, it has to go.
We were in the position that we would have to find about £50,000 a year just for doing nothing. So we decided the only thing to do was to pull the mill down, which is what we did. And the mill actually was the Articles of Association they started up in 1913, and the mill, with a whole lot of people buying shares, and in 1915 the mill was completely built, and we started weaving. And my wife's grandfather, Hartley Edmondson, he bought 440 looms to start off, and we have a copy of a little notebook that he sent the order off, and in it he bought 440 looms at £7.10 each.
I'd always been here and coming down with my father to the mill and looking around it and walking around the shed, you know, and seeing all the looms running and all the rest of it. When John comes home in the from here, even now, it's got a smell at the mill of its own, which sticks to clothes quite a long time.
There are two sort of main precautions. One is at the back of the chimney, they've painted it down, and as soon as the chimney starts to move, they can see a small crack appear.
But it's just a very airline crack come through there. Now, can you see where it mortars left brick there and there?
And as soon as that comes, they know that it's getting very near when they see the crack. They've put a bottle of beer, which they've wedged. They've shaken it up first to get a good fizz into it. They've put it into the chimney, and the slightest movement will burst it. As soon as that bursts, that means it's time for them to run, to move away from the chimney. Yeah.
You cut it out to where you want it to go. You know, I mean, if we'd have cut more around this side, we'd have had it more over there, you know. You get it on half, and then you can more or less guarantee it's going, you know, where it goes.
It's a very sad day, because I've been with the company altogether for 60 years now. We just missed the 100th anniversary of the whole lot. For if it started when the Articles of Association, that was 1913, we should have had to go to 2013 to get the 100 years. We've got to 98 years.
I went inside the chimney yesterday, and yes, it was amazing how thick those walls are at the bottom. And you could look out and see the light at the top, which looked like the moon almost. I wouldn't want to light it either. John's going to do that.
I've got a flame now, that's right. I'll get a picture of it.
I'll get it going properly first.
It'll be a bit of a sad, the fact that it's an end of an era altogether. But there's no sort of alternative about it. The mere fact is that we're half an hour from the motorway, and there were a lot of empty mills and cone, Nelson and Burnley that could be used for storage, means that our time is over.
God bless all those who ever worked here.
Well, I feel very sad about it. You feel very sad. It's just, it's the end of an era, isn't it? Perhaps it's something, you know, these things have their lifetime, don't they? It's a shame.
God, what has wrapped up the chimney? The chimney has been 96 years old. Yes.
I don't like seeing them come down. Every time one comes down, it's a job less, but that's where it's gone, isn't it? You know, this little, a soft sand and lime old mill chimney, they tend to crumble when they're coming down. But this allowed together with old bands on, it'll come all in one.
Characters in the era. I went to see a Mrs. Jackson, who actually taught my son to weave, Peter, when he was about 18. She went to Robinson Court, and when she was in her 80s, I cropped in to see her from time to time, and she said, John, she said, if you decide to start up weaving again, she said, I wish you'd found me 4 looms and I'll come back and start weaving again for you. She said, they're the happiest years of my life.
Oh, it went perfect. Absolutely perfect, that. Brilliant. Do we get it machined in here now?
Cheese.
What did you think of that?
Oh yeah, good. Yeah. I've been here since about 12 o'clock, so we're listening to him jackhammering away and then we're waiting, weren't we? We sat up roof of the car over there waiting for the fire.
Right.
You liked it though, didn't you?
Yes.
We're coming to watch, weren't you?
Yeah.
Exciting.
Very exciting. Very exciting, yeah. Good. Never seen one before. They're not so very many more, will they?
No. It took a bit longer to come down than we thought. It must have been well built. And good. It's a very thick wall too. It's about 5 feet, 5 or 6 feet thick, the actual brick.